some real science. They're all set. Right, ladies and gentlemen, are you keen to find out what all of this is about? That didn't sound anywhere near enthusiastic enough. I'm going to try you again. Look, there's two different colours of thing, and these are like magic. They're see-through. How does that work? Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to find out what this is about? Yeah. Would you please welcome to the stage, Martin from Lockheed!
Hello, everyone. Oh, let's start, see if it's work. Yeah. Tonight I would like to show you a few experiments about fire and ice. So let's get started. First, let me explain you this diagram you can see above. It basically represents the four basic states of matter. There is more, but we're not going to discuss them today. As you can see solid state, liquid, gas and plasma. And the arrows represent the phase changing between them. So we all aware of some of them, like melting, freezing, condensation and vaporization. But we not every day we can observe the other ones, like sublimation, deposition and ionization. And that's what I would like to show you today. So I'm going to do a few experiments with dry ice, which dry ice is basically the solid form of carbon dioxide, and it's very, very cold, about minus 79 degrees. And then I'm going to show you experiment with hot ice. And this is basically how to quickly make an ice for a party. And as you can see, the hot ice is a super saturated solution of sodium acetate and water. And finally, I'm going to show you a video of experiment with plasma and a microwave. And plasma is basically ionized gas, which means the electrons are separated from the nucleus. And what distinguishes plasma from gas is that plasma becomes conductive and it responds to electromagnetic field. And another interesting thing about plasma is that plasma is actually 99% of the visible matter in the universe. And not because of plasma TVs. It's all because all stars are made of plasma, like our sun. So let's start. First, I would like to show you how to actually make dry ice at home, so you can see the CO2 fire extinguisher. Yes, it's very professional video. So you have to put a small cloth around the home, squeeze the grip, and in a few seconds we can have dry ice and we're ready for a party. This is example of deposition, which means the carbon dioxide in a gas form changing phase to solid. So in few seconds, as you can see, we have a nice bit of dry ice. Okay, so let me show you the opposite process now, and I'm going to try to show you live. So I've got a little bit dry ice here as well, so let me fill that glass container. Glass, I don't want to say it's for glass beer, but let's see if we can show the process of sublimation. Okay, I think that's enough. It's not looking very spectacular at the moment, so let me put some warm water to speed up the process. Just put the microphone in. Okay, and we're ready. So yeah. So that's pretty cool trick for a party. this is example of sublimation process, so this is exactly opposite to deposition. So first we're making a dry ice and then we can use it like that and to show our fans. Another experiment we can do with dry ice is a floating bubble, so just in case I won't be able to do it here, I made a video as well. So as you can see, in that glass bowl, put some dry ice on the bottom, and if you put the bubble, it actually float. So I'm going to try to do it here as well. So I'm going to put the microphone down again. Let's put some dry ice on the bottom of the bowl. Okay. And now I'm going to use that super professional gun. No, it's not one of the ray guns, so you're all safe. So let's see if we can make some bubbles and see if I can make them float. I don't know if everyone see, but some of the bubbles actually floating in the air. That's why I made the video. Probably people in the first row can see some of them, as you can see, floating. So yeah, this is an example of the bubble gun. not deadly. Okay. So what else we can do with dry ice? Another cool thing about dry ice is that dry ice can actually sing. And trust me, can sing better than me. That's what my wife told me, at least. So you will see the dry ice singing quite nice, to be honest. So let's see if I can make a dry ice sing.
No.
That's it, I hope you heard. So if you didn't like this singing, you won't like mine, apparently. Okay, so that's enough about dry ice. So let's see, experiment with hot ice. So that's, like I said, that's a quick way to make an ice for a party. Only joking, it's not for consumption. So this is the process of making it. You can see the crystal form of sodium acetate, and we have to dissolve that in a warm water. Once it's dissolved, we have to cool that solution down, and then we need something to start the reaction, for example, small piece of crystal of sodium acetate. You will see in a minute. I was going to do it here as well, live, but unfortunately it's very, very delicate thing, so the ice is already made, so I can't do it here. So you can see, in a few seconds, we can actually receive ice. And this is an example of exothermic reaction, which means the heat is actually given away to the environment. If you would touch that glass, it actually feels very, very warm. So let's go quickly, I've got 2 minutes. I promised you some experiment with fire as well. So let's, there we go, nice shot of ice. So let's see some experiment with plasma. Quickly, we can create a flame in a microwave using just the fruits. Grapes, for example, if you see, I can make a grape sparking, like you see. All you have to do, you have to just cut it in the right size and put it in the right position. I used about 2 kilograms of grapes, which my wife wasn't happy about. So if you put the small jar on top of the grape, there is a small chance you can actually make small amount of plasma, which is the ionization process. And but that again, I know it's very professional video, I know. For a second you will see small cloud of plasma rising to the top. It was, wow. But that's not very spectacular, so there's another way. Don't do it at home. Instead creating flame from the grape, we can actually put a match inside the microwave. I know, it's an easy way, I know, but my wife said she won't buy me any more grapes, so, okay. And in a few seconds, you can actually see a nice little ball of plasma. Just watch, there we go. So this is plasma, and as you can see, the color of the light changed. It's kind of blue and white. This is because it's very warm, over 10,000 degrees. As you know, the higher temperature, the color is different. You can't keep it running for a long time. You damage your microwave. So 10-15 seconds is a maximum, and I have to buy a new one now. So. Okay, I think that's it. Thank you very much, and enjoy your evening.
That's it for Blondie, ladies and gentlemen! Now, normally I wouldn't dare to speak on behalf of the Science Festival. I fear that I can say on behalf of the Manchester Science Festival, don't do that with your microwave. Because they don't want to be liable. If you've been enjoying the festival so far, if you want to tweet about the festival, it's hashtag MSF14. I picked up a brochure on the way here just to see some of the stuff that's on. Make sure if you're going to Bright Club on the Thursday. Well, at least one of the organisers is here, so... So Brighton Manchester's on Thursday. That's kind of like this, but a bit less chaotic and messy, and a bit slicker, a bit more professional. I was also looking, they've got some really good films on, and Prometheus. Does anyone else watch that and just think, run sideways? Why don't you just run sideways? Terribly disappointing film. I thought it was going to be the best thing ever. I've been excited about that for 4 years.